AWS stands for the Amazon Web Services, which is the cloud computing division of Amazon. We were the pioneers in developing the concept of cloud computing, which in the earlier days meant that IT services like compute, storage, databases, networking, security could be accessed as a service over the internet. And that completely revolutionized the way that companies are using IT. Now these days, it's much more extensive. It's more than 15 years old by now. And I think we have well over 200 different services, no longer what we called in the earlier days infrastructure as a service. But it's much richer now, whether it's machine learning and analytics and mobile development and enterprise applications, IoT. There isn't an area of IT that AWS isn't serving today over the internet for anybody to use, whether it's a small business, a startup, or to the largest enterprises. I'm of course extremely excited about the region that we're going to launch here in the UAE in the first half of 2022. So let me first explain what an infrastructure region is. Yeah, so it's basically a collection of data centers. We call them availability zones. They're separated from each other such that no natural disasters can take out all the data centers. We now have 25 of these regions around the world and 80 availability zones. It's important to have an infrastructure region local to meet latency requirements, such that these days, you know, everybody's accessing digital services all the time, and latency plays a very important role in that. The other reason for having a local infrastructure region is to meet regulatory requirements. Yeah, take, for example, First Abu Dhabi Bank is, of course, strictly regulated and can now start moving more and more of their IT services into the cloud because if there is a local infrastructure region. Now, digital transformation for many companies is a matter of survival. Yeah, they really want to be able to compete with the fast, young businesses that are out there. So speed is very important. And so what you can do in the cloud in AWS is that you can start building new digital services really rapidly. Where in the past, maybe developing a new feature or a new service may have taken 2 years, in the cloud, you can do this in basically 5 days. Yeah, and so speed of development, getting new services in the hands of your customers makes that these enterprises can compete better. Now take, for example, a local company here, Aramex. Yeah, they're going through a digital transformation. And in the past, if they would have wanted to make use of machine learning, they would have had to buy very expensive equipment, get experts to help out. But now with AWS, they're able to make use of AWS SageMaker, which is our machine learning platform, which does not require machine learning expertise, nor do you have to buy any hardware. Well, if you talk to many startups, they will tell you without cloud, they would never have been able to get off the ground. Look at what our household names today. Here in the region, Karim, Souk, all startups that have grown up on the cloud and actually have now been acquired, of course, by Uber and by Amazon. But there's all these companies that are only able to start building their digital services because there is cloud. And yeah, look at household names, whether it's Uber or Airbnb or Dropbox or all these Spotify, all of them are household names today, but they're all startups that have grown up on the cloud. Now, there's a very interesting paper by an article in the Harvard Business Review that describes that because AWS existed, we have seen 4 times as much investment in young businesses. So we see an enormous explosion in young businesses being built just because AWS is there. We see, because of the pandemic, that there has been an increased reliance on digital services. Yeah, you can take companies that run on AWS like Zoom. As you can imagine, I think in the fall of 2019, they had about 100 million participants on a daily basis on a monthly basis. But at the beginning of the pandemic, that rose to 300 million. And of course, companies like that who deliver digital services have seen an enormous rise. And they've only been able to do that because they were on the cloud. Because if they would have had to do this on their own hardware, they would have waited 6 months before a service get delivered. And whether that is Zoom or whether it's Netflix, who saw a 40% rise in the watching of movies during the day alone. On the other hand, of course, there's a whole range of companies that have been negatively affected. Now, think about the airline industry. Think about the travel industry. And we've been working closely with them to actually make sure that they can reduce their cost as much as possible. Now, of course, we've all more and more are reliant on these digital services. And one particular area, I think, of course, is that of remote learning. Yeah, education has shifted to being completely virtual. Aleph Education here in the UAE is one of those companies that provided a remote learning platform, runs completely on AWS, and were able to scale up really quickly to meet the new needs of learning. Given that data sets are growing larger and larger and larger, it's no longer possible for humans to look at the data. You really need advanced tech technologies. And the key there is machine learning. Basically, data sets are growing so large that you can make use of machine learning to discover patterns in there. And I think that's only becoming more and more important. I honestly think that we are just on the beginning of how are you making use of machine learning. So machine learning basically takes data, finds patterns in there, and then creates a model where you can ask questions to. Now imagine you're a retailer. They probably sit on a history of billions of orders. And they can make use of that history, of that data, to look for fraudulent patterns. And they can, when you do that, you train on the data, and out of that comes what's called a model. And this model you can ask questions to. For example, if you get a new order, you can put it in the model and it will tell you what the likelihood is that this is a fraudulent order or not. So it has all these applications these days because the data sets are growing so large. Now, whether you talk about autonomous cars or individual trucking or anything these days runs on machine learning models, security will be forever a number one priority. Why? Because, you know, bad actors are moving as fast as everybody else. And as such, security is our number one priority in terms of whether it's capital investment or whether it's people investment. This is the area we will always be looking at first to invest in. Now, if I look back 10, 15 years, you know, there was lots of reasons why enterprises were moving to the cloud. Whether it's cost savings or speed of development or, you know, getting rid of hardware refresh cycles, all these kind of things. These days, the number one reason why companies are moving to AWS is security. Companies are starting to realize that they cannot get the same level of protection by doing it themselves, because that world of security is moving too fast. And as such, enterprises are moving over to AWS because there they can get the security that they really need. We're able to do innovation in the security space with services that are absolutely not available on-premise and with enterprises themselves. So security is the absolute number one priority. And we're also, for example, not only for enterprises, but for young businesses, startups. We're really teaching them that security should be built in from the ground up. It cannot be an afterthought, because then you can never protect your services. So we have a whole very rich set of security services, which our customers can use on day one when they're building new services, or when they actually have existing ones that they want to migrate over to AWS.